हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू आवर सोशल स्टडीज़ क्लास। ओपन पेज नंबर 7, आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ दिस टर्म, स्टार्ट विद द एवोल्यूशन ऑफ मैन। आवर फर्स्ट रीड द आंसर्स, रीड एंड आंसर्स, यू आर सपोज टू रीड दिस एंड आंसर दीज क्वेश्चंस। विच एनिमल रिजेंबल्स अ मैन मोस्ट, यू मस्ट बी नोइंग, आई थिंक यू ऑल नो वेरी वेल, दैट इज़ योर एप्स। Name one animal which looked like an elephant and lived in primitive times. Primitive means olden times, and it is now extinct. Extinct means not in existence. That is your mammoth. Name any two food items which you think that the early humans ate. Okay, they were eating fruits as well as this raw flesh. Okay, come to the human evolution. Actually, this human evolution, it deals with your human evolution. Okay, it deals with your, again, origin of human. What origin of human? Remember, human evolution means how this man started living. Okay, it deals with it. And now all the human, we all human are belonging to the same species. Okay. Human is given the name, biological name is given to the human. That is, what is the biological name given to the human? That is your homo. Okay. Now modern man. Modern man. So now modern name is given to its homo sapiens. Now, what is the meaning? This sapien means thought. A man has the ability to think. This is the reason this name is given to the man. So, now come to here. But underline this, the biological name for human or a man is homo. Because sometimes they can ask you in your brain gain or in your fill-ups or in your true-false also. Okay? In any form, they can ask you. So, the first Homo sapiens, the ancestor of today's human, evolved around 2 lakh years ago. Okay, so first this our ancestor, okay, was when we found it 2 lakh years ago. It was. Okay, it was evolved 2 lakh years ago. The science that is concerned, underlying this beta, the science that is concerned with finding out how human evolution happened is called physical anthropology. The science that is concerned with finding out how human evolution happened is called physical anthropology. So, the people, those who are again making a studies how this human evolution happened, that science is called as a, that study is called as a physical anthropology. So what this science tells, it explores how human race developed. Again, how they were again making a guesses, they were using the ancient human fossils. Okay, what are the fossils now? Fossils are remains. Okay, they were using the human fossils and tools and signs of human life. Okay, to tell us about how they were, how they developed. Next comes our Ice Age. So what is Ice Age? Ice Age is a time period when much of the Earth's water is frozen in glacier. So, throughout time, Earth has experienced several ice ages. Okay, children? So, during the ice age, things they become cold. So, weather was the only thing which can warm it again. So, even this each ice age takes a lot of time to again recycle itself. Okay? And oceans, they were becoming day by day smaller, and the water was again free, water become less. Why? Because it freezes into ice. Okay, so it was believed, it is now also believed, that because of the cooler temperature, the man was forced again to change its area. So again here it is believed cooler temperature forced change on early human.
whatever the changes take place in early human, these changes were taken place because of the cooler temperature. Next comes bichha, because of the cooler temperature, what happened? Either they have to live that in that area only, new environment which was not suitable to them, or they have to migrate. Underline the word migrate. Migrate means moving from one place to other. So what happened during that last ice age? As the sea level it dropped down, it came, water was very less. So land, again bridges were made like this, two land bridges, you may say. This is a land. So bridges were made with the help of this way bridge was made. Okay beta, between island and the continents. Okay, so early human actually was first found in Africa only. So that was their native place, but because of this climatic changes, they have to move from there, okay, from Africa. Now comes the theory with man and apes. For ages we were believing that man and ape were related to each other because of their basic structure. Anatomy means basic structure. But this you have to learn. This is, it's given here also in your brain again. This you have to learn for your exams also. Because of the basic structure, what we all were believing? We were believing that they both are same. Then comes our Charles Darwin. Who? Charles Darwin. He was a biologist. He gave a theory of evolution. In that theory, he told that this basic structure comes from a common origin of group, because this man was again belonging to that common group only. That which common group? Ape common group. Okay, get it all of you? Apes and man are closely related to each other, and even why? Because they biologists believe that a man is also a primate. What is a primate? Means animal. Okay, so man and this ape and man are close relative, because ape is also animal and we also were animals. So primates actually are a mammals, okay, which includes your monkeys, apes and all. In 18th century, scientists gave a new theory. They believe that great apes were closely related to human. What they thought? That great apes were closely related to human. Now in 19th century, what happened? Again in 19th century, they thought that the only closest living relative of humans were either chimpanzees or gorillas. Okay, why they were thinking that chimpanzees close relative of a human? Because of the species. Okay, because they it is believed that the chimpanzee species is closest to us. Okay, this was believed actually. Then final conclusion was made, and conclusion? That human are not only similar to the great apes, but again great ape themselves. Okay, scientist says that human is great ape. Okay children, next comes our stages of human evolution. But if early human, or you may say what we call another name is hominids given to it, was first appeared in Africa. Where it was appeared in Africa. So this first stage, what we call this first stage is your this Australopithecus. What we call this stage? Australopithecus Southern Ape.
The picture is also given. You can see the picture of Australopithecus here given it is. Okay, this is your that Australopithecus. Okay, they were living naked. Okay, what they were eating? They were eating animals, fruits, nuts, insects and worms. Okay, next stage comes Homo habilis. Okay, this this stage was having an advanced feature of human like. Okay, this means present human. It was looking like this. Okay, in about 1.8 million year ago. Next stage come, that was third stage come 1.8 million year ago, that was Homo erectus. Which stage has come? Homo erectus. Homo mean man's, erectus means upright. So what was the meaning of this Homo erectus? Upright man. Okay, so Homo, again this Homo habilis also given, this is your Homo erectus given. You can see the pictures from here. Okay, next stage is our Neanderthal. Neanderthal man came into existence. Okay, and finally the Homo sapien, which is now we call a wise human being, which we are right now. The first Homo sapien had a heavier build and was stronger than modern human. Okay, that was very stronger. Now, evidence of early man. As we all know that this early man, it was early human were nomads. What are the nomads? Those who were again moving from one place to other, not staying on one place. Okay, they were nomads. They lived in a natural homes like caves or on a tree tops. Okay, children, that you know very well, I think so. They usually, sometimes they do not wear anything, otherwise they were covering themselves with the leaves. Okay, they were covering themselves with the leaves or animal skin. Okay, they were not knowing how to read and write. So because of this, because they were not knowing how to read and write, so we are not having any written record of their time. Our knowledge comes from only from where we come to know that these four stages were we read so many stages, 4-5 stages we read, from where we come to know we are having a fossils remains. Okay, and we got some cave paintings, from there we come to know how they were living, how they were looking like, and we got some stone tools, okay, which they were using at that time. Okay, children, move to the next topic comes our fossils. Fossils were actually remains of living things. What happened that those remains, when they are living for a long time, what happened? They turned into stone, or sometime that left an impression on a stone. Okay, in early 1920s, the hominid fossil were first discovered in Africa. Okay, where it was first discovered, human fossil was discovered, it was in 1920s it was covered. The remain showed the impression of tiny skull or a brain. Skull, you all understand. What was the again impression? That was a brain, small brain we got there. That impression was small. Its shape was rounded, unlike that of chimpanzees. Okay. And gorillas, more like modern human brain. It was not looking like the brain of chimpanzees, but more like our human brain. Okay, this was the reason why we believe that it was the only human skull found. Okay, in 1974, again most famous fossilized bones were found. Okay, these fossilized bones were given the name Lucy. Okay, children, and it is a collection of fossilized bone, and when once made up the skeleton,
we meet the skeleton of these fossilized bones. Okay, and when we made the skeleton, that we saw that it was the skeleton of female. It was believed that female skeleton means one must be living. She must have lived in Ethiopia about 3.2 million years ago. Am I clear to you all, children? Next comes our cave paintings. Early human, they do not know how to express themselves. Okay, they were not knowing reading and writing. The only way of expression was that they can have a drawing. They used to draw to express themselves. Again, from where we come to know that they were drawing, we found some of the drawings of theirs in our caves. Okay, that these drawing reflects their different moods of early human. So when what we find in those cave painting, that we'll study later, but we come to know that the first cave painting was not discovered by the archaeologist. Okay, it was found first in France. Actually, some children, they were playing in the jungle. Okay, when they were playing in the jungle, all of a sudden they discovered the entrance to cave. Actually, that entrance was covered by the trees. This way they saw that, and paintings were found. Now, what were in those paintings? Pictures of animals and things were there. Most often, what kind of scenes were there? That was of animal or hunting scenes were found. The colors which was used for again paintings and all, but that were made of natural dyes from fruits and plants. Okay, children, the color, you know, na, every plant is having its own color. You must be knowing about henna, mehndi. Okay, the girls are applying, that also comes from a plant only. Every plant is having a different color. Flowers are having a different color. From there, they were using those, making those natural dyes. And even they were using the charcoal again for doing those paintings. Though we do not know much about this early human, yet it is believed that it took thousands of years to again give up that nomadic life and settle down in a life which was much closer to a modern human. This is all in your beta, this evolution of man. In next video, I'll discuss with you the question answers and back-end exercises.